Hello, my dear students. Today, we are going to discuss about the characteristics of the DC generators, which is the last topic in the third unit. So there are two types of characteristics. One is the magnetization characteristics, and the other one is load characteristics. Magnetization characteristics are nothing but a graph drawn between the no load voltage G and the field current IF when the speed of the generator is maintained constant. It is also called as no load characteristics or open circuit characteristics, because at no load condition these plots are taken. So this is a plot between E versus IF. We know that the no load induced EMF is equal to 5P ZMP by 60A. From this, the EMF is proportional to flux, where flux is proportional to IF. When the flux increases, then IF increases, then E naught increases. You can see the relationship. So, from this graph, it can be observed that as the IF increases, that means field current increases, the voltage also increasing linearly up to some portion. Once it reaches the rated voltage, still when the field current increases, slowly there is a little increase in the voltage E naught, and after that it reaches the saturation, that is called, it will be constant. So the voltage remains constant after saturation. The key point we can observe here is the characteristics is linear till saturation, and after that it bends such that voltage remains constant though IF increases. This EMF also varies with speed. When the speed changes, this characteristics with particular speed, when the characteristics changes, that means when the speed changes, the characteristics also changing. For different speeds, different characteristics can be obtained. So we can observe here different speeds, n equal to n3, n2, n1. When the speed increases, the EMF increases. That means is a family of parallel characteristics. For lower speeds, the generated voltage is less. For higher speeds, the generated voltage is more. Next, coming to the load characteristics, these are again two types: external characteristics and internal characteristics. External characteristics are nothing but the characteristics drawn between terminal voltage versus load current IL. Internal characteristics are nothing but a graph drawn between the EMF E versus IA. For both these characteristics, the speed of the generator is maintained constant. Generally, in most of the cases, we know the relationship between IL, IA, ISH. Generally, this ISH is neglected, which is a small portion, because the field winding current is less, because the field winding resistance is more. That ISH can be neglected. Then IA is equal to IL. Therefore, in place of IA, we can take IL while drawing the internal characteristics. So if you take the separately excited DC generator, so we can observe magnetization and load characteristics. So we'll see here different types of generators, that is separately excited generators, self-excited generators, and the self-excited again, DC shunt generator, series generator, compound generator, those characteristics. Separately excited generator, you know this diagram. The armature, the field winding is separately excited, where DC voltage is a variable resistance to get different field currents. the field current is varied, the EMF development will be varied. So this is the circuit diagram which can be used for experimental purpose also, where EMF will be measured with voltmeter and current will be measured with ammeter. So first let us see the magnetization or open circuit characteristics of a separately excited DC generator. So here E naught versus IF, if you see, it is as same as the previous characteristics what we have explained. As the IF increases, E naught increases, and after reaching certain field current IF, the flux will be saturated. Therefore, IF will be, even IF increases, the EMF will be constant because the flux is constant. Next, let us see the load saturation curve. The load saturation curve is a curve drawn between the voltages versus the field current. Here we will see different voltages, that is no load voltage, load voltage and full load voltage. Here we have already seen the no load voltage curve, that means OCC curve with respect to field current, that means E voltage with respect to field current. Now if you see the load and the full load curves, so what is the difference between these two if you observe? So it is a, that means the graph is a terminal voltage Vt against the field current IF. When the generator is loaded, normally what happens, the armature current also increases. That means as the load current increases, the armature current increases. When the armature current increases, there exists armature reaction. Already have explained that armature reaction is due to the load current. That means under loaded condition only, there will be an effect of armature flux on main flux. That means the armature flux disturbs the main flux so that the EMF will be reduced. So due to this, what happens? Due to the armature reaction, the terminal voltage Vt, which is less than the no load voltage. So this reduction is due to armature reaction compared to the no load condition. So that's why we can see this OB is nothing but the ampere turns from no load to full load condition. Under no load condition, these are the ampere turns required to produce particular voltage. Under loaded condition, to produce the same voltage, it needs additional ampere turns. It is due to demagnetizing effect of the armature reaction. So these are equal to, as I told, BC. Similarly, there is a drop IARA compared to load characteristics to full load characteristics. A IARA drop will be existing. Because of this IARA drop, there is a further reduction. That means the characteristics will be below the normal load characteristics. This IARA drop, that is armature resistance drop, will make the terminal voltage to reduce. So this graph is shown by OR. That means this is the graph shown. This triangle PQR is called drop reaction triangle. So you can see this is the drop due to armature reaction, this is the drop due to armature resistance drop. So here OP is a no load saturation curve, and OQ is the graph of generated voltage on no load, and OR is the graph of terminal voltage on load condition. we'll come to the internal characteristics and external characteristics. So these are the characteristics drawn between V versus IL, which is nothing but external characteristics. E versus IL is internal characteristics. Under no load condition, you can take the EMF E constant. Compared to this EMF, so there is a drop in the voltage due to armature reaction drop. That means due to armature reaction, there is a drop in the voltage compared to no load, which is called internal characteristics. And due to armature resistance drop, you can see the difference between E and VT. That means VT is equal to E minus IRA. There is a further drop. So this is the these are the characteristics for the separately excited generators. These characteristics are drawn for constant field current. Next, come to the characteristics of the shunt generator. That means a self-excited generator. You know how the shunt generator is connected. So the shunt field is connected in parallel to the armature and load is connected. The terminal voltage VT is IL, ISH and IL. Load characteristics are nothing but these are the characteristics drawn between VT versus IL. And internal characteristics are nothing but E versus IL, as I already explained. So if you see the internal characteristics, you can observe under loaded condition, as the armature current increases, that means the armature current is depending upon the load current. That means as the load current increases, obviously the armature current increases. As the armature current increases, armature reaction effect will be increased. Therefore, we can observe as the IA or IL increases, there is a drop in the voltage E. The effect of the flux produced by armature on the main flux produced by the field winding is called armature reaction. So because of the armature reaction, there is a reduction in the EMF. Let us see the external characteristics. As we told, the external characteristics are drawn between VT versus IL. So you know that E is equal to VT plus IRA. So as the load current IL increases, IA increases. As the IA increases, V decreases. Because the value of the armature resistance is very small, the drop in the terminal voltage as the load increases is very small from no load to full load. Therefore, the DC shunt generators are called as constant voltage generators. Another important topic in the DC shunt generator is why shunt generator load characteristics turns back when overloaded. You can see here there is a drop in the voltage E, small drop up to the point P. This drop is due to, that means this drop is due to load. As we told, this is due to armature reaction as well as armature resistance drop. So here we said normally this from E naught to P, if you see the load resistance decreases, hence the load current increases. And due to IARA, the armature reaction and the voltage decreases by a small amount. Hence, these characters are dropping in nature. That means this drop is due to, and there is an increase in the load current. There is a load current. When there is a load current increase, then what happens? And due to IARA and armature reaction, this voltage drop you can observe. After the point P, if the load resistance is further reduced, that means beyond the point P, then what happens? IL is increased. Normally, when the load resistance is reduced, IL increases. Beyond P, then what happens? This is a very large current and generator gets overloaded. When the generator gets overloaded, due to such large current, armature reaction will be very severe. Obviously, when the load current increases, armature reaction effect will be increased. And also the drop IARA also will be very large. Because IARA is large and load current, that means armature reaction effect is more, definitely there is a severe reduction in the terminal voltage VT. VT is equal to E minus IARA as well as armature reaction. So there is a drastic decrease in the voltage V you can observe here from P to Q1 to Q2 or reaching some point, the terminal voltage becomes zero. So thus, on the curve PQR, the voltage goes on reducing rapidly, and at the point R, this voltage becomes zero. Thus, beyond P, if the generator is loaded, then what happens? The load characteristics turns back till the generator gets short circuited, and the curve meets x-axis at a point R where the voltage is zero. So we can observe some key points in this case. In portion E0 to P, that means from E0 to P, the effect of decrease in the load resistance dominates the effect of the change in VT. That means here we can observe two effects. One is this decrease is mainly due to the load resistance, and this portion is due to the drastic reduction in the VT. There are two effects. So in the portion PQR, the drastic reduction in the VT dominates the effect of the decrease in the load resistance. Hence the curve returns back. That means there are two effects you can observe. One is load resistance effect, and the one is terminal voltage effect. This portion is load resistance effect. This portion is terminal voltage effect. Let us see the load characteristics of the DC series generator. You know, in the series generator, this field is connected in series with the armature, where IA is equal to ISC, ISC is equal to IL. You know the relationship, IA, ISC, and IL. As the load increases, obviously IL increases, ISC increases, where ISC is the main cause for the field flux. Therefore, flux increases. That means here, and the ISC increases, IA also increases, therefore armature reaction effect will be increased. So the characteristics of the E against the internal characteristics is of increasing in nature. As the IA increases, armature reaction increases, but its effect is negligible compared to the increase in E. That means the armature reaction effect increase is negligible and compared to the increase in flux effect. That means the when the flux increases, the EMF increases. At the same time, when the load current increases, the armature reaction increases. So, but this increase in EMF is more dominating when compared to the armature reaction effect. That's why we can see rise in the characteristics. You can see the rise in the characteristics. So this is the OCC characteristics, magnetization characteristics, which is E versus L. So this portion, already you know about the residual flux. That means even though the field current is zero, then there will be some amount of the flux will be there, which is a residual flux. As I told you, just like a residual memory. So some EMF will be developed initially, just a small portion. And as the field current increases, that means IS increases, the EMF increases. Coming to the internal characteristics, here we can observe. So the internal characteristics are nothing but E versus IL or IA here. E starts decreasing due to armature reaction. But in this case, it is very less, it has very less effect on the EMF. As IL is equal to IA, that means load current increases, RA plus RAC increases. Therefore, there is a drop in the VT, which is equal to E minus IA into RA plus RAC. There is a drop in the V. That's why we can observe the difference between E and VT characteristics here, respect to IF. So this is due to armature resistance or RS effect, and this is due to armature reaction effect. We can observe there is a rising curve characteristics. So we can see some points we have discussed already. The external characteristics is also rising nature as E increases, but it will be below the internal characteristics. Always can see the external characteristics are below the internal characteristics because of the drop IA into RA plus RSU. In the self-excited CC series generator, open circuit characteristics cannot be obtained. This is a very important point you have to observe, because as there is no load, that means IL equal to zero, obviously IA is equal to zero. Therefore, no induced EMF. It is different from DC shunt generator. So we cannot obtain the open circuit characteristics. So the open circuit characteristics is possible only by separately exciting field winding. It is also shown in the figure. In practice, when there is no load, that means IL equal to zero, there exists certain induced EMF due to residual flux retained in the field winding. Hence, for zero load current, there is a voltage present, and the internal and external characteristics do not pass through origin. So this is one point you have to remember. So coming to the load characteristics of the DC compound generator. You know there are two types of compound generators. One is cumulatively compound, and the other one is differentially compound generators. So if you see here, the flux phi SC, that means one is series field and the other one is shunt field. Already we told about the series and shunt fields, windings, shunt field windings. The series field have less number of turns, and shunt will have more number of turns. So when the series field phi SC and shunt field phi SH, and they are in the same direction, then the flux will be cumulative. That means phi T is equal to shunt and series field flux. As the load current increases, IA increases normally. As IA increases, ISC also increasing, producing more flux. Thus, the induced EMF also increases, and terminal voltage also increases. That means as the flux increases, EMF increases, and the EMF increases, the terminal voltage also increases. VT is equal to E minus IR. But as IA increases, there are various voltage drops. That means one is armature reaction drop, another one is armature resistance drop. Both will be increasing. So if you see here, there are different characteristics. Power compounded, flat compounded, under compounded, and differentially compounded generators. If the drop in VT due to increasing IL is more dominating than the increase in VT due to increase in flux, then the generator is called under compounded. Means what? Under compound generator, if you see here, there is a drop in the voltage as IL is increasing. That means a drop in VT due to increasing in IL is more dominating than increase in VT due to increase in flux. But here you can see two effects. As the load increases, that means IL increases. Obviously, IA increases. When the IA increases, what happens? IRA drop and the reaction drop. These two are increasing. When that increase in armature resistance and armature reaction is dominating when compared to increase in voltage due to increase in flux, then it is under compounded generator. That means characteristics are decreasing like this. But if the drop in VT due to armature reaction, other drops, is much less than the increase in VT due to increase in flux, the generator is for over compounded generator. Means what? When under cumulative compound generators, the flux increases, EMF increases. When the EMF increases, VT increases. That increase in VT is dominating when compared to the armature resistance and armature reaction drops due to increase in load. Then obviously what happens is just like a series generator, the characteristics are rising in nature. These are called over compound generator characteristics. If the effects of the two are such that on full load current, VT is same as the no load induced EMF, then the effects are neutralizing each other on full load, then the generator is called flat compounded or level compounded generator. That means even though the flux is increasing, the increase in EMF as well as when the flux increases, that means cumulative compound generator flux, why it increases? Because of IA. And when the load increases, what happens? Obviously, armature reaction and armature resistance also increases. When these two effects, that means increase in VT and this voltage drop effects, when these are neutralized, then what happens? Then it is a flat compounded characteristics like this. That's what we explained here. The effects are neutralizing each other. That means increase in VT as well as no load induced EMF. These two effects. That means if the effects of the two are such that on full load current, that means IL, VT is same as no load induced EMF. That means the two effects are neutralizing. Then it is a flat compounded generator. Let us see the differentially compounded generator characteristics. You can see differentially compounded generator means the series flux and the shunt flux are opposite to each other. Obviously, the net flux is decreasing. Therefore, the net flux decreases. Then what happens? Obviously, the EMF produced will be reduced. So, you can observe here, in differentially compounded, phi d is equal to phi sh minus phi sg. The net flux is the difference between the two. As the IL increases, phi sh is almost constant. We know that the shunt field current is almost constant. Therefore, phi sh is constant. The only variable component is phi sg, series flux, which increases rapidly. When the series flux increases, what happens? Total flux will be decreasing. Hence, the induced EMF and hence the terminal voltage also decreases. And the flux decreases because E is proportional to phi. EMF decreases, therefore the terminal voltage also decreases. There is a drop due to armature resistance, series field resistance, armature reaction, due to which the terminal voltage drops further. Thus, we get the characteristics of such differentially coupled generator as shown like this. That means it's just like the characteristics what I have shown, I have seen previously for the DC generator, shunt generator. So there is a drastic drop in the voltage due to reaction in the flux, like this. Thank you.